so many times we have blessings that we fail to account for. Because we're so busy looking for this miraculous thing to happen, and we don't realize we've already been given major blessings already.
Yes, yes.
Am I right about it?
Yes.
So we take for granted the blessings we already have.
Yes.
One of the first times I was talking about this with you, I was talking about the blessing of just life, health, and strength.
Yes, yes.
If you were able to get up out of your bed and get out of it this morning and be in worship this morning, that's a blessing.
Yes.
There are so many people who wish they had that opportunity that you had this morning. Amen?
Amen.
There are so many people that wish they had the clothes you have on. Are y'all quiet? There are so many people that wish they were able to wear and have the clothes that you have on this morning. Things we just take for granted. Amen? Things we take for granted. I've learned to be thankful. That's why one of the blessings is the blessing of thankfulness. If you have a thankful heart, that's a blessing that opens you up to blessings that you won't have room enough to receive.
Amen.
We used to call it this, an attitude of gratitude.
Yes, yes.
Somebody say an attitude of gratitude.
Yes.
That just means you have a thankful heart. I'm just thankful about everything. Someday, I just a spirit of just thank you, Father, just comes over me. And I'll be thankful about the little things, thankful about whatever I have for breakfast, not just blessing it, but being thankful for it.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Thankful for what you have, a place to live.
Yeah. Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Somebody say thankfulness.
Thankfulness.
Thankful for a church family.
Yes.
That is growing. When I come here and I see you all coming here and you're coming here so excited, and people are greeting one another and so much love.
Yeah.
I'm so thankful for a church. Let me just take a little side path. A church that is about the love of God.
Amen.
Do you not know how many people I have to listen to during the week that talk about going to a church where there's no love?
Yeah.
And I want to say to them, here's Global Elvis. And I also want to say, well, why are you going there? If you're going to a church where it's calling itself a church where we understand that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life, and that church foundation is not built on the love of God, why are you wasting your time? You don't have to go there. Well, the Bible says forsake not the assembling of yourselves together. Well, don't forsake, just find a church where there's love.
Amen.
Tell somebody about Global Harvest. Amen. Because people are hurting for a church where they can find the love of God. And it's not about the church. The love is because we have a family who loves the church that love, the building that is.
Yeah.
But the family of God is where the love is.
Yeah.
And that's where the blessing is. Somebody shout, the blessing.
The blessing.
When we talk about the blessing, one of the scriptures I want to use this morning, it comes from Proverbs 10:22. And this is the Amplified Version. Proverbs 10:22 says, the blessing of the Lord, it makes truly rich. Somebody say, truly rich.
Truly rich.
This is the blessing of the Lord. It makes truly rich. Now, next week I'm going to talk about some riches that we tend not to pay attention to. Because many of us are rich and don't even know it. There are monetary riches, and then there are true riches.
Yes.
There is a difference between monetary riches and true riches.
Yes.
Are you following me?
Yes.
Money, I had one of my students that was signing out of class, and I said, where you going? Class is not over. Well, I gotta go, Mr. Brown. Well, what are you in such a hurry for? You haven't even finished your work today. I gotta go make that money. I gotta go make that paper. I gotta go make that paper. Okay, that's hood rich. There's a difference between hood rich and truly rich. Because let me tell you what truly rich is. Truly rich is having and knowing the peace, the love, and the power of God. But just in case you didn't get enough of gives me a companion called grace.
Yes.
So with the blessing comes grace.
Yes.
Which means you can't abuse the blessing because grace got you.
Yes.
Tell somebody, no matter what happens, grace has got me.
Along with my blessing
comes the grace of God. Thank you. Grace is the companion of the blessing.
Yes.
The blessing that is truly, that makes us truly rich, comes with the companion of grace. Somebody say grace. To make sure, he says in this commentary, to make sure that no grief for the loss. There's no grief for the loss and no guilt for the abuse of it. That means you can't abuse this blessing. How can you abuse something that was freely given to you? This is the blessing. You can't use too much of the blessing. Amen? Now, when we think about the blessing, here's where we take another little turn in the next 10 minutes. 10 to 15 minutes. Now, when we understand the blessing, there are not just blessings, but there are blessings multiplied. But blessings multiplied, many times we forget that they are according to. So there are blessings on each and every one of our lives. For many of the blessings, there is the ultimate blessing, but then there are the multiplied blessings. And the multiplied blessings in many cases are according to. Somebody say according to.
According to,
when we look at the according to blessings, I want to try and give you four. I might not make it through all four because it's so powerful. I might have to spread it out between this Sunday and next Sunday, but if I get through all four, I'll be doing good. The first blessing is according to your faith. According to your faith. And when Jesus departed thence, two blind men followed him, crying and saying, Thou son of David, have mercy on us. And when he was come into the house, the blind men came to him. They came to him. Somebody said they came to him. And Jesus said unto them, Believe ye that I am able to do this? Somebody said, believe.
Believe
that I am able to do this.
That I am able to do this.
Anybody believe that he's able to do it?
Yes.
Then what happened? Then said unto him, Yea, Lord. Then touched he their eyes, saying, According to your faith, be it unto you. There are so many things that we are waiting for that God wants to do, but it's according to your faith. These blind men wanted to be healed. And Jesus said, Do you believe that I can do this? They said, Yes, Lord, I believe. He said, Then according to your faith, be it done unto you. In other words, you're getting this not as much about me as it is about the fact that you believe that I am able to do this. So many people miss blessings that they want because they don't believe that God can do it. Oh no, Pastor, not me. I believe. Well, why don't you have it? Because there's some unconscious doubt somewhere that is holding up, because when you truly believe something, nothing can stop you. Jesus says, well, according to your faith, be it done.